Hi, and welcome back to Philly Changer Chats. My name is Sharon Rice, and today I'm with Iris Leone. She is the chair of EPIP Philadelphia, and she's here to talk about EPIP and what they're doing in Philadelphia, in the city, and for the community. So, hi, Iris, it's so great to see you today.
Thanks for having me. I'm really, really pleased to be here.
Yeah, great. So, tell us a little bit about EPIP. Like, what is the organization, sure. and what does EPIP stand for, even?
Sure. Well, it literally stands for the Emerging Practitioners in Philanthropy, which we just lovingly refer to as EPIP. And EPIP is a national network of not exclusively foundation professionals, but individuals interested in social change and social entrepreneurship, and who really want to advance and see a just and equitable world through philanthropy. So equity is really an important part of the lens that EPIP brings to emerging leadership in philanthropy. We also are highly focused on leadership itself and nurturing individuals in philanthropy who are emerging at various stages of their career. So it's not necessarily exclusively 40 and under crowd. You can really be emerging at any stage in your career. So we don't really look at new leaders in the workforce. It's newer leaders in philanthropy, which really can be at any particular point in one's career.
Great. So. Oh, that's great. So it sounds as though anyone in Philadelphia can kind of get involved.
That's right.
And if they have an interest in philanthropy or if they're working in philanthropy, they can get connected.
And one of the reasons why EPIP exists is really to fill a void in having stepping stones to enter the world of philanthropy. So it's a hard field to enter, and people don't necessarily leave their jobs, but we still need emerging leaders in the field. So, you know, so EPIP was created in large part to address that kind of a gap. It's not necessarily that there aren't enough people in the field, it's that there aren't avenues or to nurture people within the field and to enter it. And particularly with a lens towards equity and advancing equity, that, you know, we don't have, diverse people in philanthropy either, at least not to the degree that we'd really want to see. So EPIP exists in part to kind of redress some of those equity issues around who, quite literally, who is working in the field. Mm-hmm. So here in Philadelphia, we really try to be as inclusive as possible in terms of who we invite to come to our programs and who we consider to be our, you know, members. Mm-hmm. So many people, including myself at one point, we weren't necessarily employed within philanthropy. We were representing other kinds of social change areas. You know, I'm basically a career fundraiser, so I'm on the total, was on the total opposite end of the spectrum. But we try to be as inclusive as possible so that we're really reaching not just as many people as possible, but the right people too. You know, if we're talking about how we distribute funds and how we make change through philanthropy, you know, we have to have a broad range of people in on that conversation, not just the people who hold the purse strings.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the lens that we bring that might be distinct from other professional groups.
That's great, that's great. And you mentioned making change, and that's something that is very evident here in Philadelphia. There's so much happening around social justice, even coming out of 2014. What are some ways that you see EPIP sort of giving into the voice of social impact, particularly here in the city?
Yeah, I mean, I think we definitely try to remind ourselves that philanthropy is a big part of it's the chief thing that we're here to address, but that as I kind of mentioned, that it's if we're only including people who are formally in, you know, in their day jobs, that their 9-to-5 roles are at a private foundation or a family foundation or a corporate foundation, that we're leaving a lot of people out of that equation. So I think that's part of what we do, is that, you know, we try to open up not just the conversation, but who we want at the table. And if you look at a lot of folks who come to our events, we're almost sort of having this issue around membership where we have to try to reach out to foundation folks more and more, because we have so many other people who are interested in what we do, which is great. I mean, that's part of the point. But so I think that inclusiveness is a really defining characteristic for EPIP Philly in particular.
That's great. Yeah. That's great. That's awesome. So you know, as we're sort of wrapping up, what would you say would be like a main takeaway that you've had with your involvement of EPIP, and what could you tell the community about it?
Yeah, well, I'll just give an illustrative example about my own kind of career trajectory. I, as I mentioned, have been mostly in the fundraising world, so in the nonprofit sector pretty much exclusively in my career, but EPIP really was instrumental in helping me identify my own personal career goals and really solidifying philanthropy as the space that I wanted to inhabit for professionally moving forward. So I've been involved with EPIP for about 4 years now and very recently assumed a new position. So I'm now the executive director of the Delaware County Community Foundation. So I've made that shift. And I can tell you that EPIP was, you know, without EPIP, I wouldn't be in this role. But what's significant about it is that, you know, I think the whole part of the purpose is not just to have conversations about philanthropy, but really to improve practice. It's about improving the practice of philanthropy as well.
Right.
So I take that away, and I hope I'm employing that in my new role now, which is amazing that I now have this opportunity to really create an organization that I want to work for, and that the grant making that we do and the way that we represent Delaware County will be reflective of my value system, of what EPIP's value system is around justice and equity. So I think it's been really important for me, and I think I actually need EPIP now more than ever now that I've gotten to this role.
Right.
Now what? You know, so that's been really, really important for me personally.
That's great. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.